I'd like to start the discussion of the PI AF database by showing you what you can do with it. Here's a display in ProcessBook that is designed to be element relative. And what that means is, as I choose these different elements, these are elements in what's known as AF. When I choose these different elements, we change the display to show what's appropriate for that particular context. So that's what you can do with it. Now let's take a look at what the actual structure is. If you've worked with the PI system for a long time and you haven't seen AF before, I think this is a huge difference. This is a huge change from what you would normally expect to see with PI. What we're looking at is a hierarchy. This is something called the PI System Explorer. PI System Explorer is our primary view into something called AF, our asset database. It's a view into a system that's, as you can see, hierarchically based. And what it represents for the PI system is a fundamental change of how people will be able to find things in the PI system. Up until AF, we would take, I guess, what you would call the Rolodex approach to finding PI tags. Let me give you an example. You know, typically, if I wanted to build something in ProcessBook, I would go and do a tag search and use the tag search to find whatever it is I'm interested in by typing in either a tag name mask, or maybe the name of the engineering units, or a partial descriptor. In any case, it was a simple lookup. It's like going through a Rolodex and saying, well, what's that plumber's name again? We would organize things simply in a big long list from A through Z, and that might work with maybe 2,000, 5,000 tags. Even then it gets kind of clumsy. But when you're talking about 150,000 point systems, 1.5 million point systems, then the Rolodex approach doesn't really work very well. And besides, when you're just simply searching for things, once you find those things, you may want to find related objects, objects related to the thing that you're looking for. And if all you have is something that's the equivalent of a Rolodex, well, there's really no structure there that tells you what might be related. And unless you were extremely clever when you first came up with your naming convention, then there's going to be some things that you've probably missed in your naming convention where, you know, somebody creates a calculation or an aggregation that you just forget about. The person who comes and takes over managing the system doesn't know it's there. So, for example, here is a tag search looking for underscore int, and it's showing these different energy usage. We have three different energy usage tags that have that tag mask. Now, I know for a fact that there's a fourth tag that is related to these three tags. Unfortunately, that fourth tag doesn't fit the naming convention. It was created a few months later, and it was a totalization. So for me to find that particular tag, I would have to know that it begins with the letters underscore TOT, and then I would go out and I would find, you know, that particular process value. So anyway, because we find there are so many customers that would have these large systems and they would like a better mechanism for navigating, what we've created is more of a hierarchical view of looking at your PI data. So what we're looking at here ultimately is exactly the same set of PI tags that we saw before. As I switch between these different what we call elements within AF, you can take a look down here and find those are pointers that are pointing to those same tags that we found in our tag search. And you can see that over here. As I switch from one element to the next, you'll see that each of these is a reference to a PI tag. So instead of having to search for them using this tag search, you know, in which I supplied a specific tag mask, instead of that, what I can do is simply drill down through the AF Explorer. And in this case, I'm drilling down geographically. I said, okay, within the San Leandro office, within our power distribution, you know, within this particular component, under inputs, these are the four things organized underneath that particular structure, that element structure there. Now, the beauty of this is, as I said, we're grouping these together in some way that makes sense logically, in this case geographically. So do you remember earlier when I searched and I found these three measures of temperature use, or excuse me, of energy use, but I didn't find the totalization? Well, now you can't miss it. It's sitting right here in this list. So if you're the person who inherits this PI system from some previous system manager, you're going to see right away, oh, he's already done an aggregation that totalizes this. You don't need to know what that naming convention is. I like the analogy that Buck Bard, our training manager, uses when he teaches this class. You know, he says, if we're going to go out and meet at a restaurant, I could sit down and say, okay, it's a restaurant, it's Chinese food, it's got, you know, two stories, there's parking in the back. He can do all this, and then you'd have to go out and look through all the restaurants in town for that restaurant. Or he can just give you the address. And if he gives you the street address, then you'll just go right there and find it. Now, I'd like to build on that analogy one more. Within that, you know, if you do go out to that restaurant's going to have a menu. You can look at it, right? If you were to go to a different restaurant, that restaurant would also have an object that we call a menu. In fact, almost every restaurant you're going to go to is going to have a menu. Well, one of the things that you can do with these elements is if there are objects that are common between the elements, like, for example, a menu is common among restaurants, then you can make element relative displays. In other words, you can say, hey, go to that restaurant and open that menu, or in the case of working within, oh, for example, an equipment list, when we're talking about flow meters, you can say, go to the Montreal, you know, equipment list, go to flow meter 01 and look at the flow rate. Or you could say, let's go to a different geographical location instead of Montreal. Let's go to Houston. Within that same structure, let's go to flow meter 01 within Houston and look at flow rate. Both of them represent flows, and both of them have a flow rate, just like each restaurant has a menu. Now, these things we call attributes, and when they're in common like that, when there are attributes in common, then you can make what we call these element relative displays. Now, in the case of this element relative display, what we're looking at is a series of tanks. Each one of these tanks has two variables. Let me just hover over this so you can see it. It has a level, which is blue, and it has an inside temperature. These are tanks. As I switch from one tank to the next, each one of those tanks has an inside temperature in red and a level in blue. There we go. Yeah, the E dot that you see there, that's our indication that this is element relative. And as I keep switching, you know, one to the next, each one of these tanks, just like each restaurant has a menu, each one of these tanks has a level and an inside temperature. And we're going to look at whatever is the appropriate level and inside temperature given the current context. And context is the other concept we need to go over. As I hover, or as I switch from one to the next, I'm looking at these three different tanks here. Let's go to Houston. Take a look at the little balloon help that just appeared in yellow there. You notice the context. Big long context is telling me, let me go back there. It's telling me it's under OSIsoft Enterprises, Geography. Yeah, here we go. OSIsoft Enterprises, Geography, Houston, Chemicals Division, etc., Mixing Room, Houston Tank 001. That is the current context. It's a very important technical term that we use all throughout our discussions of AF. So please keep in mind, when we talk about context, we're simply talking about the address. It's like saying, which restaurant am I looking at? You know, if I'm sitting in a Chinese restaurant and I say the word menu, it's going to show me a menu. But if I'm sitting in a Mexican restaurant and I see a menu, it's going to show me a different menu. It depends on the context. So if I switch over now to Montreal, let's take a look at that context. Yeah. By selecting this, now take a look at the context here. This context, OSIsoft, Geography, Montreal, Chemicals, Production, Mixing Room, etc. Different context because we're at a different part of your plant. Now, one final thing about AF is that so far we've been talking about assets as though they exist solely in the real world. You know, there is a city called Houston. In the city called Houston, we have a chemicals division, there's an equipment list, et cetera, et cetera. Well, that's only one of the many ways we could have organized this. In fact, that's probably the way I would guess the engineers would want to look at it, organizing it by location and then within specific different parts of your organization where you would find that particular production value. Well, that's not necessarily going to be the same way The yield accountants want to look at it. The yield accountants may say, well, we need to divide things by division. So they have all the different tanks underneath the chemicals division, all the different different power consumption under the power division, etc. They don't really care. I mean, they do break it down eventually, but for them, it's more important that they group these at that level. And so when we talk about this hierarchy here, it's a hierarchy that can be using any kind of a structure that you want. So for example, other types of organizations you might want would be the E&I technicians, the instrument technicians. They may organize this neither by division nor by geography, but by the manufacturer of that particular piece of equipment. So if there's some kind of a recall or some kind of an issue, recalibration problems, you can go through and immediately find all those pieces of equipment based on the manufacturer or based on the install date or based on who installed it. So that's a different way that you could organize this structure. Now, I mentioned it one more time, but I just want to reiterate this technical term that we use when we get down to the actual point at which we're going to be looking at data. That level of organization we call an attribute. See, each of these that we're looking at here so far, Houston, chemicals, equipment, flow meter, etc., those are all elements. Elements are organizational structures. Once you actually need to get access to some actual data of interest, something that actually shows you either the real-time value or a lookup in a table or perhaps an installation date, once you need to get to that actual information, we call that structure an attribute. And you'll notice, especially if we go into tanks here, you'll notice when we get the specific tanks, those attributes, there's not just going to be a one-for-one relationship between elements and attributes. There are some elements, like for example, this tank here, that has many different attributes. It's got an inside temperature, a level, outside temperature, the product that you're making, the current diameter of that tank, etc. So these are all the different things, we call them attributes. And the attributes can be things such as you can see right here, this is just a simple string reference. It could be some type of a calculation, or it can be, here's a calculation, or it can be a reference to a PI tag. We also have the ability to do lookups to relational databases. Now, in this class, we don't go into much more detail about AF than that. What we are going to do, however, in this class is we're going to ask you to build not an AF structure, but we're going to ask you to use an AF structure to create an AF element relative display. And what we're going to be doing is exploiting the fact that within an AF structure, you may have many different contexts like reactor 1, 2, 3, etc. Within those contexts, if you have attributes that are identical, like for example, if all of those contexts have an attribute called temperature, then you can build an element relative display such that instead of having the user required to remember the names of these tags, instead of that, all he has to know is what the name of the attribute is, and then supply the proper context, and we will translate that into showing the right PI tag.